Hi, I'm Carl, and this movie is the third in a series that takes a closer look at the features, setup, and programming of Yamaha's iPad app called ProVisionaire Touch. This time, we'll be seeing how to import a remote control setup list into your iPad, and how to assign the MRX parameters as well as MTX parameters to your ProVisionaire Touch widgets. Firstly, if you're using an MRX 7D, make sure you watch the movie that covers the exporting and sending of a remote control setup list from MRX Designer. Do this before you try to assign parameters inside your ProVisionaire Touch design. When you open up ProVisionaire Touch again and load your file with your access code, it'll probably be in the main display screen. To go into edit mode, you should touch the top left of the screen, after which you'll need to enter as an administrator. Go into design mode at the top of the screen and then click on device management along the top. It's in device management that we select the MRX and or MTX devices that we wish to control. Choose add device and select those in your network. If you choose an MRX 7D model and then click remote control setup list, the list that you sent to your iPad should now appear as an option. Choose that RCSL file and then give the device a name. I'm also going to add an MTX 5D, assign it an ID number and give it a name. There is no RCSL file that needs to be associated with it because ProVisionaire Touch already has the list of parameters for this device. Back to the main screen, choosing a widget or fader that I wish to assign to, I touch it and I see the option parameter. Clicking on parameter, a new window opens up to show the two devices. If I click on MRX 7D, I can choose from the list of parameters that I exported in my remote control setup list. Select a parameter from the list and click Done. Alternatively, if I select the MTX 5D, it will give me a preset list of all available parameters to choose from. Again, hit Done and the parameter is assigned. It's worth highlighting here, as it sometimes misleads people, that it is the parameters highlighted in grey that will be your choice and not in white. Now, if we're assigning to a button widget rather than a fader, when we select parameter from the menu, we get an extra mode menu appear at the top of the page. It's here that we assign other options, such as multiple parameter assignment, preset, and snapshot recall to your button. Back on the main page, if I briefly switch to control mode rather than design mode, you'll notice a little yellow symbol appear by your widgets. This means that a parameter is assigned, but you're not yet connected to the devices on the network. Let's take a quick look at how to get your network online and working. First, I need to have a wireless access point connected to my network. The MRX and MTX are both connected via their primary Dante ports to a 1 gigabit switch. Remember, it's Dante, so it needs to be a 1 gigabit switch. The wireless access point that I'm using is also connected to the switch. In iPad settings, make sure that your Wi-Fi is connected to this wireless access point. Next, you need to make sure that your MTX editor design is online by clicking here. We'll need to sync the changes in the MTX editor to our devices. Then, on your iPad, make sure you're not in design mode, and then go to the main control window that you access by touching the arrow in the top left of your screen. You should see that the yellow symbols have now disappeared and that the widgets have now taken control of your faders and buttons in your design. Once you're satisfied that it's working well, create your admin and user passwords and hand over the ProVisionaire Touch to your customer. Finally, to create copies of your design for other iPads, you can select Send from the window of ProVisionaire Touch and then airdrop or email the ProVisionaire Touch file to another device and open it as before. I hope this has been useful. For more information, go to the links on the screen. Thank you for watching.